Exciting new features coming from Airtable's AI, and this week we want to dive into how you can build new custom interfaces using nothing more than a chat prompt with AI. That's right, unique custom interfaces specifically built for you can be yours with the right access to the AI Omni, making sure that you've turned the right components on in Airtable and enabled the right settings for your account. So if learning how to build your own custom interfaces with brand new widgets is of interest to you, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth, and this is Gap Consulting. It's our mission here to help you unlock the full potential of no-code tools, and Airtable is one of those tools that we talk about on a regular basis and use in the vast majority of our projects. Now, as I said at the top of this video, we're going to be taking a look at this new AI feature. But before we get to that, I'm going to first invite you to join me for some free training. If you're new to Airtable and you want to master the basics, grab my crash course. It is going to deliver to your inbox over a course of days, and you're going to learn the key features that make Airtable such a unique and amazing software. Sign up for that crash course at gapconsulting.io/airtable-crash-course. But without further ado, let's go ahead and hop on into my screen and take a look at the new Omni custom interfaces. We're talking about mixing vibe coding here with your interfaces. And to kick things off on the right foot, I'm going to show you what I've already built with one simple prompt. Then we're going to go through how you get this access, make sure everything is turned on appropriately for your account, and then we're going to further iterate. So here you go. You see, this is a live interactive, like this is real data for our business. And what I wanted to see was a heat map. I wanted to see our different active consultants, and I wanted to see who was busiest on what days. Now, this is not perfect. This is one prompt, and you can see here in the upper left that I've only given it one prompt so far, but this custom interface element was built from that prompt, and it took the AI, Omni AI, less than 2.5 minutes to generate the code to produce this heat map. Now, as I said, it's not perfect. We want to tweak it a little bit, and we're going to do that in this video. But before we get to actually tweaking this and going live with our new element, let's first talk about how you access these components. There's a couple of different places you need to know about, and they weren't immediately obvious to me. So the first one is going to be turning on these settings inside of your workspace. So if you are in a free or a team workspace, you'll access this accordingly. So you'll find the workspace. In this case, I will use Gap Consulting 1.0 right here. You click on that workspace from the Airtable dashboard, and then you go over to the three dots and select workspace settings. Inside of the settings, once these load, you need to make sure to swing on over to the AI component and toggle on AI labs. So right here, you'll see the workspace AI permissions. We have to have early access to the new AI features because this is one of those features. On the other hand, if you are working from a business or enterprise scale plan, then your admins are going to need to go into that. So let's go ahead and drop into my enterprise or my business plan here. And I'm going to go back to the Airtable dashboard. And so from here in the upper right corner, this is again for the more premium accounts. You can select up here and you can go down to admin panel. And this is going to have the same setting. It's just in a little bit different of a place. You click on settings here on the left hand side and then AI settings. Make sure again that you've toggled on that AI labs. If you haven't turned this on, you're not going to get access to these new features. And in fact, while we're in here, you're going to see that there's another feature as well that we're going to have to talk about in another video. But for now, make sure you've turned this on in whatever different workspaces you're using in Airtable if you want to turn on this new feature. So once we've got these things toggled on, then we have to head over to the data. So here I am in interfaces. And as I said, this is live data here. And we could not do this from the data layer. We have to be doing this in the interfaces. And one component that I struggled with earlier was I was initially trying to have this conversation with the Omni bot inside of the interface. So to show you what that looks like, When you first come to an interface, very often you'll see something like this. This is the active published interface. So I'm actively inside of that. And when I was coming over here, I was trying to type in Omni in the bottom right corner. So this is not going to cut it. This Omni is not for building things inside of your Airtable interfaces or in your database. So if you want to actually put something new into play that doesn't already exist in your solution, this is not the place. This is great for asking recommendations, having questions about your data, maybe analyzing some questions about what you have in your interface. Perfect for those use cases. When you're actually building, this is not the right AI to use. However, you can access, assuming that you have the right level of permissions, you can access it by going up here into the upper left corner, selecting Edit Pages. This takes you into build mode, but you're still not quite there. On the left-hand side, you're gonna find the Omni AI. And we have to open this up, but more importantly, when we do this, we need to make sure that we've turned on the tools. So if you're building a new element, as we've done here, click on Tools, and then bring in your AI-generated element. Now, you might pause here and say, what is that web table? Well, that's that other new feature I was telling you about. We're gonna have to cover it in another video in the interest of time. So here we are with our AI-generated element. Select this, and then go ahead and type out your prompt. Now, for me, this created a brand new interface. Now, I've heard tell that you can also add this to existing dashboards if you're adding a new element inside of the dashboard. Although I haven't tested that myself, it's reported pretty widely that that is the case. So you can build these custom elements inside of a dashboard that already exists, or, as I've done here, create a brand new page. So what I'm gonna do is actually edit this page. So I wanna select this element, and you can see that it's already on that AI-generated element here. And there's a couple of things that I wanna make changes to. I want to add a filter that shows me the status of the consultants. Now, all I've done is type out a prompt, as you can see. Add a filter that shows the status of consultants, and let me filter the available data in the heat map with this filter. Let's go ahead and hit enter and see how long it takes, because I know at a glance that not all of these consultants are currently active on our team. Some of them worked with us years ago, some of them even more recently, but we want to make sure that we're able to see relevant information. And so if I want to see what's currently happening in my business now, I need these kinds of filters in play. So I'm going to keep the camera running here so that we can see the actual build time of this element. So, you know, ultimately, when it comes to vibe coding, this is a factor to take into consideration. Would it be faster for you to build it yourself using code, or use the AI component and generate that code with an AI prompt? And frankly, for someone like me, most of the time, my coding is not very strong at all, and so it's much easier for me to rely on this. But that, of course, has its drawbacks. The drawback, the key drawback being, if something is not quite right, you don't necessarily always know it right away. This is the big complaint about vibe coding, is the fact that we're just going off of the vibe. Does it feel right? Does it pass the sniff test or the gut check? And so I really don't like the fact that we can't troubleshoot and actually fix the actual underlying elements because, again, we're just talking to the prompt here. So as you can see, that has completed in probably what was 90 seconds or thereabouts. And it's added some filters for us so that we can look at the status of the consultations. And I've actually kept this in my initial prompt. I said, I want you to draw up a heat map for me that shows only the completed consultations. And then here it's showing me a list of consultants. So it's not quite what I had in mind. And this is kind of the problem behind vibe coding. I was hoping for an easy little filter where I had a drop down of my single select that either said current status is active or inactive. And that's not what it gave me. But I can come in and you know, toggle on or off different consultants within the team here and get that kind of output, which is pretty good. So one thing you'll notice, though, is, of course, that this heat map is using aggregate data. And what I had envisioned essentially was looking at the consultants. I wanted to see what days of the week are they taking the majority of their calls. But I also wanted to see for those consultants, how busy are they relative to their workload? So if a new consultant has only been with us, as in Christina's case, for a short period of time, it's not really fair that I'm seeing this data compared to the 200 consultations that have been completed by Ali on a Monday. So what I was imagining was instead breaking this down and seeing this data on a much more, row by row or consultant level. So I'm going to ask if can we update the heat map stats per consultant and not use the color coding for the aggregate numbers, but instead the consultants individually. And again, as it comes to vibe coding, as we wait for this to think, this is one of those things where if I were coding this, it would take me days, frankly. But here we're able to talk to a prompt, spit in our concept, and maybe it gets completed on the first pass, and maybe it takes a few tries. So while we're waiting for that to process, just a couple of other thoughts on the new elements. Number one, it's important to note that when you share interfaces with people, they can ask the AI to analyze the data underneath, but they can only get responses that are relevant to the information you've given them permission to see. So any kind of permissions in terms of what you want people to have access to are maintained, and the AI bots will not betray that information. That's, of course, a very important thing to note, that you can have a lot of sensitive data behind the scenes, and when you are sharing interfaces and encouraging your team to engage with the AI, you don't have to worry about them seeing stuff that is not relevant to them. But here we go, another 90 seconds or so gone by, and we have an updated and very improved heat map, because now we're seeing data that is relative to that individual consultant. So at a glance, I can see Eric's busiest days are Monday and Tuesday. Wednesday are pretty busy for him as well, and things really peter out on Thursday. And of course, we don't encourage our consultants to do a lot of work on the weekends, so it's really only if they decided to work an hour or two extra. And so we don't expect to see a lot of time on the weekends there. So that is better data, because it's no longer comparing Eric's numbers to Ali's numbers, where there's a big discrepancy in the number of completed consultations. So just like that, we've created this brand new element inside of our interface with a few prompts, and literally it's been three. I gave one initial prompt to kick off the video, and then we've done two iterations here on with the cameras rolling. It's a pretty impressive output. In all honesty, I'm really excited about where AI is taking this, and I've heard a lot of mixed responses, a lot of people saying that jobs are going to be lost, and I'm sure that there's a lot of truth in that, but we can't neglect the fact that people are getting better results faster with the software that we love, and there is something beneficial and positive about that. So, let me know your thoughts below. Drop me a note and share your opinions. And of course, if you got value from the video, we'd love a thumbs up and of course subscribe to the channel. That being said, if there's something we didn't cover, swing by our website, because we have a ton of resources available for you there. But most importantly, my friends, keep on building.